That's kind of funny. I don't know. All right, we got our headliner coming up. Yeah. I love this dude. One of my favorite comics in the scene. This is it. This is the end of the show, all right? If you got any energy left, go crazy. Start clapping now. Start clapping. Make it loud for G. Way!
Lean up. I said my niggas don't dance. We just pull up our pants and do the rock away. Now lean back. Lean back. Lean back. Lean back. Come on.
Y'all ain't got no energy in this motherfucker. You hear that song, you got, hey, turn it up one more time. Where the DJ at? Is the DJ here? Come on, right here, I see you. You heard this before. Just lean back, one time. I gotta keep it. Ah, how y'all doing today? Covert Cafe, we having a good time. Shout out to all the comedians that you've seen grace this stage tonight. You know what I mean? Give it to them. Give it up for Lucas. Give it up for Brandon. Yeah, okay. Stop with that shit. Now it's about me. It's all about me now. You know what I mean? I'm a storytelling comic, so I like for people to really pay attention when I start talking. Because when I start talking, if I say something and you miss it, that's your fault. That makes sense? Yeah. For me, this is therapy, nigga. It's the cheapest way to do it. The cheapest way to do it. I done broke up with another therapist a couple weeks ago. You know, my second therapist. We broke up and shit. It's fucked up, huh? It's like a real relationship. I broke up with my first one because I was seeing this motherfucker for like 3 years, right? And we was really tapping in. And then I came in one day and the nigga tried to sell me drugs. That's weird. You know what I mean? You come in and they're like, hey, man, I'm... As much as you talking to me, I think you need something different. Something stronger. I don't know if I can help you. Put out that pad. I was like, man, come on, man. It's talk therapy, you know. So I had to leave him, you know. It's fucked up. Bad breakup, but that was my choice, you know. Uh-huh. I tried another therapist. She was cool, but when I went to therapy with her, I just felt like she was talking more about herself than me. Like, I was like, Tracy, I don't need to know that Kimberly and Justy Lynn are now in high school. I don't need to know that. This is about me. You know what I mean? It's good. It's good, you know. So now I was like, I'm going to tell jokes because now I get therapists and all you niggas can be my therapist for the night. Y'all with that? Y'all consenting adults? Y'all going to be my therapist? Y'all in for some shit. This brain is crazy. I'm telling you. I broke up with my last therapist. It was kind of weird. Right, and I hope y'all don't do me this way. My therapist came in, and we was talking, having a good talk. And then at the end of our session, he pulled out three names, three other therapists that he thought I should talk to. I thought that was nice, but at the same time, it's a fucked up breakup. You know what I mean? Y'all look like y'all been together for a while. Y'all been together for a minute? Y'all married? The best way, if you was to ever get a divorce, I don't want y'all to, though. Y'all look like a happy couple. But if you came home one day, and she had a list of three other women... Hey, I think you should talk to them, you know, because obviously you can't do this shit by yourself, nigga. You can't, you know, that's how I felt, you know. And it's weird, my therapist got mad at me the first time because I got a problem in my life, right? Like, today is my birthday. Yeah, it's good to do a show on your birthday, you know what I mean? And my therapist got mad at me because I go around and I tell people it's my birthday and it ain't. It's a great way to get free drinks, nigga. If it's your birthday, if you walk into any place and be like, hey, it's my birthday. Kamikazes for everybody. It's weird, nigga. I be having real issues in life, I think. You know, like, I had to watch the Olympics. Y'all watch that shit? You did? Yeah. It's weird watching Olympics being a black man, though. Because every time America is doing something, I'm like, hell yeah, fuck them up. Fuck them up. Fuck everybody. I get racist watching Olympics. Fuck Germany. Fuck China. Fuck Japan. I just be every other country, nigga. I just kill them. Kill them. Yeah. Then I wake up and realize I'm black, and I'm like, oh, yeah, this shit weird, nigga. And then watching the events, like, some of that shit really ain't Olympic worthy. You know what I mean? Like, sexy walking, y'all like that event? That event? Sexy walking, you know that event. They all line up at the line. Like, it's just like if, like, you was lining up for a sprint and shit, right? They all line up on a line, and then they shoot the gun like it's a real fucking race, and then they just do this. For like 7 miles and shit, nigga. Yeah, that shit that old white ladies do in your neighborhood at 5 o'clock in the morning. That's not an Olympic sport. That's this is weird. I don't know. I just want the Olympics to like be the Olympics, you know? Like for the Olympics to be interesting to me, like somebody gotta have a chance to die. Like just some kind of gladiator sport, that motherfucker. Like, you know what I mean? I think the closest we got is wrestling. And I don't know what the fuck that is. I don't know why people want to grab each other in them tight ass clothes. It's kind of homoerotic at the same time. I just want to, you know, call Diddy and get some baby oil in there. We can turn the wrestling to a freak off, niggas. That's what I, you know. But I think the Olympics would be dope if the last, like, event at the Olympics was like every country picked their best warrior and one weapon, and they just throw them into the ring and they fight to the death. Now you see why my therapist handed me them three names. I'm just saying. This is real. Everybody get to pick one weapon, you know? And I think about the different countries and like what weapons they would pick, you know? I think the French are probably like they pick like they like they a baguette. I don't quite know. I don't cigarettes and talking funny. I don't. That's Germany. They come armed with racism, nigga. Yeah. Germans are racist. I don't care what y'all say. Racist people. They fuck some shit up. I think America would win every time because we would just come armed with a nuclear bomb and just blow the shit up. You know, airplanes, that type of shit. That's how America is. Go America. I'll be cheering for America the whole fucking time too. I don't care how many people die. See what I'm saying? This is my real life. Hey, I got kids and shit. Y'all got kids? Okay. You see how unenthusiastic y'all clap was? Y'all got to deal with that shit too, huh? I hate it, but I love it at the same time because they give me so much joy in life, you know, because you get to see how innocent and how stupid they are, you know? And that's a good thing because they haven't developed their brain yet, so they're still growing. It's good to watch it, you know. My son is learning Spanish, and he don't know it. But he's trying to learn it, you know. And so he needed help with his Spanish homework, and I don't speak Spanish. So I'm not the right person to help him with, you know. And so the other day, he was asking me about words and shit. He was like, Dad, how do you say beach in Spanish? And I was like, well, I think I know that one. It's La Playa, Playa, Playa. That's what it is, right? And he was like, all right, cool, got it. And he got to another word, asked me, and I'm like, I don't know. And then he was like, okay, hold on, wait. How you say table in Spanish? And I was like, I don't know, nigga. He was like, table-o it is. Nigga, you think Spanish is just adding an O to the end of the word and it makes it Spanish? I couldn't disagree because I do that shit too. I don't know. Stupid, I don't know. Chip off the old block, I guess, you know. I got a 14-year-old daughter that's a drug dealer. And I support her because I think in life, you know, if you want to do something, you got to start doing it early, you know. LeBron James started playing basketball when he was like 6, nigga. He's LeBron James now. Mm-hmm. Every great athlete, every great scholar, they start learning when they was real young. And so if you're going to do something, you got to do it when you're young. And so I just try to encourage her to be the best drug dealer she can be, you know? I don't want her to be a stupid drug dealer, you know? I got friends nowadays that sell drugs, and I know they didn't start early. You know, because they do stupid shit. I got a friend that sell cocaine on Venmo. He take Venmo payments for cocaine, bro. And his profile is not private. You see how stupid that kind of drug dealer is? One day I was scrolling. I had to get shit about a Venmo. You know, you can scroll through and see what people sent. And I seen a message to him for $300. And at the bottom of the message, it was just an 8-ball and a snowflake. That nigga going to jail. He needed a father, somebody to help him. Nah, my daughter ain't a real drug dealer. She's a capitalist. One day, I came home, right? And she was baking cookies and pies and cakes and shit. She was just getting her chef on. And I was like, oh, that's dope. Took an interest in it. I'm a father. You know, I'm going to help her out. Go get some supplies and shit. And then I got a call from the teacher about 2 days later. And they said she was going to school selling kids cookies and telling them they was edibles. She didn't have no real weed in it. But at the same time, like, you know, it's a bunch of weird ass kids thinking they high. Nigga, that's sugar, you know. I think we're going to have to suspend her. I said, you're not sending Pablo Escobar home with me, nigga. I think, to me, that sounds like, I don't know. She wasn't hurting anybody, you know. I think she should be able to do that, but not, you know. So, and I think as a parent, you know, you got to curb your kids, you know, and teach them, like, the right and the wrong way to do it. You got to stop it. You got to nip it in the bud if it's not a good thing. You know, I really don't encourage her to be a drug dealer. So what I did in order to nip it in the bud is I hid an ounce of cocaine in a backpack and called the cops. And told her it was a kid away from the school bus selling drugs to other kids. You know, she she got a record. But it's fine, though. She doesn't like to sell dope no more, you know. I don't know. I tried to be a drug dealer. Anybody else try to be a drug dealer in their life? You say he is, but yeah. You failed at it too? I don't know. It seems like a very good job. I've seen drug dealers have a lot of money, and I was, you know, I tried when I was 14 years old. I said, oh, I'm going to try too. You know, I tried it. It was only because people were smoking crack right across the street, and I thought if I had crack and they were smoking it, I can sell them some and I can make money, you know? Entrepreneur. Entrepreneurship. That's what we breed here. Except I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know how to go about getting fucking crack, you know? So I had a homeboy who knew how to get crack. He told me the plan. He said, look, we need $20. We go across the street to the OGs. We give them $20. They give us $40 worth of crack. And mind you, the OGs was just like 16. They were selling crack for 2 years. So, you know what I mean? They had a little bit of clout on us, you know what I'm saying? He said, I came up with the plan, you come up with the money. So I gave him $20. He went across the street to the OGs. He got two crack pills. It was $20 a piece. He gave me one, he took one. And we was starting our crack selling mission, you know, on the block, hustling. This nigga was good. I think he must have went like crack prep school because he was selling crack, coming back, selling crack, coming back, selling crack, coming back, you know? And I was out there for, you know, a couple of hours, but I didn't know how to approach a grown-up and ask them if they wanted crack. If you're a 14-year-old kid, how do you come up and say, hey, sir, you look like you might smoke crack every once in a while. I don't know. I don't know your life. But would you like to buy some crack maybe? I have one. I have one of them. I got one crack right here, you know? It was awkward, nigga. I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know how he was so good. He came back about 4 hours later. He was like, man, how you doing, bro? I was like, man, I've been out here. He said, me too. He said, you got it all off? I said, no, nah, I still got it. And he was like, you still got something left? I said, no, I still got it. I got that one crack still, nigga. 4 hours later, I got it. He said, man, let me buy that for me for $10, man. Go back home, man, because this ain't for you, you know what I mean? So I sold crack for 4 hours of my life, and I lost $10, nigga. You see why I need a therapist now, huh? I'm looking for another one. That's y'all right now, I'm telling you. This is my life. The other day, something interesting happened to me. I got my ass ate for the first time. I found out I had a hemorrhoid. That was I was like, just treat it like a clip. It's not how that's done. I didn't do it. It just tickles. You know? You ever got your ass ate before? No. All right, we'll talk about something else. This was the problem. This is my therapy, nigga. I don't know. One day, I think my youngest daughter is going to murder me or somebody close to me. You know? It's kind of weird to have somebody like, she just loves me too much. You ever have somebody just look at you, stare at you? I told her I was going to cut my hair. And she said, I want to keep it. I said, why? I said, I'm going to put it in your food. And she said, I'll eat it. That's weird. Isn't that not weird? We're getting ready for school. And, you know, I'm running around doing shit. And she was like, help me with my shoes. I said, okay, I got to go to the bathroom first. She said, it's cool. I'll watch. No, you won't, you weirdo. That's fucking crazy, right? I don't know. I like to show my kids old gangster movies and shit, right? So we were sitting down, and my youngest daughter is sitting on my lap and shit. We watching this old-ass gangster movie. It's these Bloods and these Crips, and they be going at it. Yeah, you watch movies like that, too? No? Like old hood movies? Old hood movies? You watch old hood movies and shit before, right? You watch old hood movies? God damn. Y'all don't like gang movies and shit where Bloods and Crips fight each other and then they be killing each other and shit? Like, with this movie, it was this dude who was a Blood, and he went over to the Crip side, and he took one of the girls from the Crip side, and then they went to war over it, and it was nuts, nigga. Like, people was, like, dying in the street, nigga. They was, like, nigga, throwing rocks, and they was beefing over the fence and a whole bunch of other shit, right? Y'all probably seen this shit. Romeo and Juliet? You had to have seen this shit before, right? Gangster shit, nigga. But we're watching that movie, and she's sitting on my lap, and she turns and she grabs me with my face, and she goes, Dad, I just want to put your face on my face. That's what I'm saying. She loves me too much. Don't know what to do about it. Did you give me a light? Okay, cool. No, thank you. I just didn't know. We didn't discuss that beforehand, so now I'm cool. I'm comfortable now, so just, yeah, let you know. Okay. I'm just going to run. You might have to come get it from me. Pause. No, it's weird having kids, especially doing comedy, right? Because, you know, naturally your kids are going to want to do what you want to do. I got a son who wants to do comedy, but he sucks, you know. It's like he comes with a lot of dumbass one-liner jokes that I just don't like. He came to me the other day. He was like, hey, Dad, why'd the chicken cross the road? And I was like, I don't know. He said, to get to the idiot's house. And he just walked away. That's not good comedy, you know. So I had to, like I said, I had to help my kids. I got to teach them. He's going to start early. I said, bro, next time you come back, have more than one joke. You got to follow it up with something. You know what I mean? He left for a minute, came back. He said, all right, Dad, I got one for you. I said, what is it? He said, how do you put an elephant in a refrigerator? I said, I don't know. He said, you got to have a big enough refrigerator. Then he followed it up. He was like, how you put a gorilla in a refrigerator? And I was like, have a big enough refrigerator. He said, no, take the elephant out and put the gorilla in, stupid. Ha, ha, ha. Stop, please. I said, okay, son, that's okay. So now you got kind of, you building a set, you know, you got your first joke. Why the chicken cross the road? Get to the idiot's house. You got the elephant, you got the gorilla. I was like, you building a set. He was like, no, but I got one more. And I was like, all right, bro. He said, knock, knock.
Who's there?
He said, the chicken. No, that was it. See what I'm saying? If you don't listen, you might miss it. He was setting me up from the beginning when he said, why did the chicken cross the road? To get to the idiot's house. And then at the end, after all them jokes, He wrapped it up on me. I said, this nigga might be better than I thought. Yeah. You getting good, son. You... Yeah. I don't know. I got taught a lesson the other day by my 14-year-old drug dealing daughter. And I liked it. You know, it was a good lesson. It was a good lesson. We was at the house, and you know when you're just sitting down with your kids, you like to fuck with them? It was a spider, and it was crawling up behind her. And I was like, oh, watch out. He gonna bite you. And she didn't even turn to look at the spider. She just looked at me and said, why has it got to be a him? That fucked me up. I wasn't ready for that conversation. That's not a conversation I was ready for. You know what I mean? But I was like, all right, well, fuck it. Nigga, let's have it. I'm gonna dive in. I said, it's a him because it's a daddy long leg, asshole. And I figured by the name, it's a guy. Daddy long legs are hims. She was like, that's not right. And I was like, okay. The reason why I call a daddy long leg a him is the same reason why I call a ladybug a her. Makes sense, right? She said, well, that's not right either. I said, well, educate me then since I'm stupid, right? She was like, okay, when it comes to ladybugs, this is what it is. The red ones, those are girls. The yellow ones, those are boys. And I said, what about the orange ones then? And she said, they're whatever the fuck they want to be. And I was like, if this little dope dealer can figure that out, the rest of the world can too, right? Right? Yeah. I was about to get mad at her, but then she gave me $500 for the rent. So I didn't mind that she cussed at me. My name is G-Wade, man. Thank y'all for having me.
Keep it going for G-Way! That was your headliner.